Attention, Council Rock North. Please give it up for your hosts, Stephanie Ruzick and Lauren McMullen.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Mr. Council Rock North. It's our second annual Mr. CRN.
I just wanted to thank everyone for coming out to support the seniors tonight. After a grueling and rigorous application process and thorough background check, we have selected what we believe are the most suitable candidates. Now, let's meet the contestants.
Lettuce to support your shoe fetish lifestyle, so rich and famous. Robin Leach will get jealous. $500,000 for the stove. Taking trips from here to Rome. So if you ain't got no money, take your belt home.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush my hair, undress me everywhere. Imagination, life is your creation.
Come on, Barbie, let's go party.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush my hair, undress me everywhere. Imagination, life is your creation.
If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go. I could take you places you ain't never been before. Baby, take a chance or you'll never ever know. I got money in my hands that I really like to blow. Swipe on you. Chilling by the fire while we eating fondue. I don't know about me, but I know about you. So say hello to falsetto in 3, 2, swipe.
After seeing that well-choreographed routine, it's safe to say that we're in for quite the show tonight. The grandeur of Mr. CRN is brought to you by our very own senior boys. They were polished up for tonight and are sporting elegant tuxes later on, graciously rented by Shrion's Tuxes.
Tonight, the boys will be competing in an all-male beauty pageant. Dreams will both be accomplished and shattered as the boys claw their way to the top.
Yes, there will be drama. There may even be some tears. But only one will emerge the victor, the king of Council Rock North.
Tonight, we will watch as the boys impress us with their best strut down the catwalk, talent, pickup line, and attempt to dominate the ever-so-tricky question-and-answer portion. Unfortunately, due to school dress code, we had to omit the swimsuit section of the pageant.
We have six judges here with us tonight, ready to evaluate our contestants on a 1 to 10 scale based on entertainment, originality, quality, and most importantly, crowd reaction. So remember to make your voices heard. The judges are Miss Esposito, Mr. Murphy, Mr. Sherp, Mrs. O'Connell, Mrs. Woodard, and Miss Mallon.
Each of our contestants has picked a charity that they will be representing tonight. The winner of the title, Mr. CRN, will receive two free senior prom tickets and a free tuxedo rental from Sweon's Tuxes. All of the money we have raised thus far will go to the winner's charity of choice.
Now let's introduce this year's contestants. Joining us first is Alex Sobel. Alex runs women's cross country and shares a healthy bromance with his teammates. He has two dogs, Romeo and Juliet, and some say he's a hopeless romantic. So ladies, remember this name. He's a renowned philanthropist and enjoys picnics, painting, and long walks on the beach. His claim to fame was a short feature on Fox News, where he helped expose the depth and severity of teen cyberbullying on an anonymous Facebook page. He aspires to be a world-class speech shooter. He's representing Bucks County SPCA, no doubt in honor of his two pooches. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Sobel.
Spread the air pollution, both far and wide.
Next up is Alan Wong. Alan's a 17-year-old Asian American. He's a solid 174 centimeters tall. He's a solid 174 centimeters tall, and his blood type is A positive, just like his grades. His zodiac sign is Sagittarius. That's right, all you Aries and Leos. He's free next Friday. Alan enjoys long walks down the Chinatown Boulevard and spending his afternoons drinking tea and trimming bonsai trees. He is representing the Pennsylvania chapter of the Special Olympics, the one and only Alan Wong.
We have Rye Hollister up next. His charity is the Smile Train, which funds free dentistry for underprivileged kids. Rye is known for his wry sense of humor. Rye Hollister is a single father of three who flew in all the way from Toledo, Ohio, just to be here tonight. When he's not gutting salmon at work, he's busy training his show dogs, Zeus and Franklin. Combined, his two show dogs have won a total of 27 ASPCA WDD third places. Despite his illiteracy, Rye plans on earning his bachelor's degree in fictional cartography at Camden Community College this summer. He likes to think his parents are only not coming tonight simply because they don't want to watch him embarrass himself in front of the entire school.
And up next, AJ Nielsen. Weighing in at about an average of 102 size stones, AJ is a pearl of a man, and the world is his oyster. He mastered the harp while still in the womb and has been knighted by the King of Finland twice. In his free time, he indulges in croquet while crocheting for the needy. He is the best undisputed muffin baker in all of Compton County. He rides all of his horses by holding onto their underbelly, a technique he spent 16 years studying with highly specialized Hawaiian gymnasts. A man of the working class, he is a symbol of the common man. Recently, AJ has enjoyed riding Jeep Wranglers into the untamable wilderness and dominating bears. AJ's charity is Drew's Hope.
Next, we have James Zingarini. James's real name, which some of you might not know, is actually Calvin Cortazar Brodus. Cash rules everything around this handsome double. James is 5'10 and 425 pounds. An avid birdwatcher, James can spot a white-breasted cuckoo from 2 miles away. He also enjoys running in circles and destroying his chubby cousin Reed in 2K13. Lastly, James competed in rhythmic gymnastics for Belarus in last year's London Olympics. James is representing the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Next up, Dan Raffo. Dan enjoys playing piano, snowboarding, skating, and hanging out with friends in his free time. He plays volleyball year-round and holds the school's record for North's tallest player. His greatest fears include clowns, puppets, and being abducted by Guatemalan weavers. His favorite snack is pudding, and he is currently dating a fashion icon. His life dream after attending Westchester University is to become a forensic scientist for the KGB. His favorite song is Elton John's Benny and the Jets. His charity is CHOP.
And Gabe Lucci, well, Gabe Lucci doesn't really need an introduction. But if he did, he would want you to know that he's the drum captain of the Council Rock North marching band. Gabe's lowest low is when he got his PSSAs back and discovered that he only has a fourth grade level of spelling despite his senior status. This memory is also one of his shining moments because it showed him that he could, quote, get past anything if he set his heart to it, end quote. Despite difficulties in life, such as still living at home and not being able to hold a job for more than a month, he tries to keep a positive disposition. He's also very hairy. Gabe eats 3 times a day and hasn't even finished high school yet. You can feed Gabe for just pennies a day. No, really, he even eats coins. Gabe's charity is Bike the Basin.
Let's meet our next contestant. If there were a glass filled with water in front of Ryan Baker right now, he would view the glass as half full. A huge fan of sleep, he goes through a minimum of 3 REM cycles a night. His 2 heroes are Pippi Longstocking and her majestic horse. He's especially fond of their movie, a movie that changed his entire perspective on life. Ryan would like to confess to his audience that he still uses MySpace for the networking opportunities and women's deodorant simply because he likes the smell. Every Wednesday at exactly 7:12 p.m., Ryan can be found bonding with his rubber ducky and his bathtub. His biggest secret? He just loves to nibble toes and has an uncontrollable foot fetish. Reminds me of someone I used to date. He is representing Athletes Helping Athletes.
Our next contestant is Matthew Jaquinski. Matt vividly recalls a memory he will never forget. On July 10th, 1995, Matt emerged from a prison where he served 9 months' time for a crime he never committed. His months of preparation finally allowed him to escape Shawshank Redemption style through the birth canal of his mother. It transformed him forever. Because of this life-altering experience, Matt plans on majoring in gynecology. Matt also enjoys eating his grandmother's pierogies. Matt's charity is March of Dimes.
Next up, Jason Chevelle. Jason Chevelle is a man of many hats, more than which 2 of our snack backs. He often coordinates them with his outfits and sweatbands in an effort to look and feel more like Josh Josephs. One of his most honored accolades includes the reception of 2 Lynx Awards in 5th and 6th grade, bestowed upon him by Mr. Fitzpatrick. He is also the all-time leading 3rd string defensive end for Newtown Middle School heavyweight team, a title he successfully defended for the past 6 years. Jason is the undefeated kickboxing champion against all 11-year-olds nationwide. It is his goal for senior year to be finally awarded Spanish Student of the Month by his favorite senora, Senora Winokur. He boasts an impressive 0-1 record in freshman jousting matches. He is a master of 7th grade dance etiquette and is very, very Jewish. Mazel tov, Mr. Chevelle. And his charity is the soup kitchen.
Devin McIntyre is representing Salvation Army tonight. He's a unique contestant who has a deep passion for dogs and sharks. He plays a lot of Monopoly and almost beat up his little cousin last week because he thought he was cheating. Next weekend, Devin is planning to shake it up at the Northeastern Regional Team Monopoly Tournament, where he hopes to place higher than his 2012 placement of 6th place. His favorite dinosaur is the pterodactyl because of its innovative use of flight and its silent pee. His parents voted him most likely to become homeless in 5 years, and he secretly wears a puka shell necklace underneath everything he wears. According to Devin, having crescent-shaped nipples isn't all that bad. His favorite shade of white is Natalie Marr. Welcome, Devin.
And lastly, we have Andre Tarasuk. He was born and raised on a small farm outside of Chernobyl, Ukraine. As a youth, Andy enjoyed fishing. One time, Andy went fishing and was bit by a really big, multicolored, four-eyed fish. He didn't like that. When growing into a man, Andy realized he was stronger, faster, and more radioactive than his schoolmates. He also has found that he has a sixth sense that allows him to absorb radiation and make himself glow. Currently, Andy is occupied as a traffic conductor on interstate highways. He loves it. His hobbies include herding cats, making omelets, and rolling tires down hills. When Andy grows up, he wants to be the pirate that glows. His charity that he'll be representing tonight is Nec Mela Strong, the one and only Andre Tarasuk.
Let's have another round of applause for our diverse contestants. Now, I think it's time to hear from some of Council Rock's most devoted students. So,
is Ben Wild out there?
All right, you're gonna have to pardon me, I don't have my glasses on, so. So we really wanna know what you think so far.
I think the show is great. Everyone's doing a really good job. I'm not gonna say that. I love supporting Council Rock North.
Ben, what is your favorite memory at North?
Had to have been back in freshman year, science class. Had a great time with my friend John Devine. Had a couple good memories back there.
I think it's time to hear from some other students. Anybody want to give us their 2 cents on tonight? No? No takers? All right, we have Mac Emery here. Mac, what do you think so far?
I'm having a lot of fun.
Is that all?
Yeah, like a lot.
Great.
Anyone else? Deb Hudson? Deb Hudson, who are you rooting for tonight?
Everyone.
Deb, are you aware that in life, sometimes there can only be one winner?
Everyone's a winner in my life.
That's good. Sorry, Cram. Before we begin the talent portion, I want to remind everyone that Mr. Legs is the jars outside in the lobby during intermission. For those of you who don't know what Mr. Legs are, we took pictures of each contestant's legs and anonymously posted them on jars. You can vote for whomever you think has the best legs by placing money in the corresponding jar. So don't forget to do this during intermission.
So we're moving on to the talent portion now. And this portion of the evening presents quite the hurdle for these young men to surpass. They have 3 minutes to wow us with the skills that they have developed over their 17 or 18 years of experience. So, without further ado, We have Alex Sobel kicking off the show, and he is showing everyone the true definition of being a superstar. It's for you, Natalie.
Hey, Kara. I saw you dancing in the hallway. You have some nice moves. Nice moves. Ooh. Will you have this dance?
Tempo has reached critical level. Tempo has reached critical level.
Thanks for that, Alex. So, next up, we're gonna get to see Alan Wong. Alan will be eating competitively against the one and only Nick Wu. So, we'll set the clock for 2 minutes, and whoever can eat the most hot dogs in that time period will be the victor. I will count for Nick, and Steph will count for Alan.
Okay. All right. I'm setting the clock for 2 minutes. Are the contestants ready?
Yeah. Can you give us 30 seconds? Like every 30 seconds?
That is in my timing procedure. 3, 2, 1, go.
Nick grabs the first wiener.
Alan is really, really chomping down
Nick
those
Wu.
Dogs. We're only 8 seconds in and I already kind of want to vomit. Alan seems to be soaking it in water to help it go down a little easier. It seems that we do have some sort of technique here and we're only 25 seconds in.
Nick Wu is eating the bun after the wiener.
The contestants are officially a quarter of the way there. They don't show any signs of slowing.
Nick Wu is on number 2.
Alan seems to have some problems shoveling it down. He goes in for some more water. He's banging the table. It seems that he's meeting some sort of resistance.
Nick is beginning to fall behind.
Right now, it looks that we have Alan with one entire dog ahead, and we are officially halfway there.
Can we get some support from the crowd?
Now, it does look like they're running out of ketchup.
Nick Wu is finishing another bun.
Alan has gone through approximately half of the first layer.
Nick
Wu
is
lagging half of a hot dog behind.
The first layer.
Uh-oh. Alan seems to have hit a wall.
Nick Wu is not
stopping. With only
30
seconds left. 30 seconds left. All right. Since I'm announcing for Alan, I'd like everyone to give some cheers for Alan right now. He has 15 seconds.
Let's hear it for Nick Wu.
Down the home stretch. You have 6 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Put down the dogs. Put down the dogs. Let's hear it for Alan.
Woo! Let's hear it once again for Alan and Nick.
Now, to switch things up a bit, we have a very serious talent coming up next, where one of our seniors, Matthew Jaquinski, will be attempting to break an official world record.
Never in Council Rock North history has anyone attempted to break a world record until tonight. Yeah. You're right. Anyway, you all are about to see world history go down tonight. Please let me introduce Guinness Book of World Record representative Michael Wright.
It's actually Timothy Wright, but we'll give him credit for getting my last name. 1 second, excuse me. Yes, my name is Timothy Wright, and I'm a local representative for the Guinness Book of World Records. Matthew has contacted me saying he is attempting to break the current record for fastest time to consecutively break 10 watermelons. The current record time, which Matthew will need to beat, is 15.3 seconds. I have a stopwatch here, and we'll record Matthew's time. Whenever you're ready. Whenever you're ready. Okay, go. Sir, I'm sorry, but the only time you broke is the fastest time to annoy me.
Should I interview more people?
Mom, turn off the camera. We're going home.
Thank you, Matt. So, as of now, we're going to hear from the judges what they think so far. Mal, baby. Hey. What do you think?
I think that we are just the luckiest people to be in the presence of such classy, talented gentlemen. Alex Sobel? I mean, is who's going to prom with him? Like, this is an important question.
Alana Rae Rothstein.
Excuse me.
That would be one Miss Alana Rae Rothstein.
Well, that is the luckiest woman in the world, in my opinion.
Sure. I think it's safe to say that you're somewhat of an institution here at North. From what I hear, you have your own currency. So I was wondering if you could maybe give us a fresh perspective on what we've all just witnessed.
Well, I'll tell you, as a teacher at North, I am proud that I fix stupid every day. But obviously, some people got through. Now, it's amazing. So far, we've seen an entertaining show. Sympathetic vomiting aside, that was a close one. We'll
okay.
see.
Okay.
We'll see how's it go.
Thank you, judges.
Wow. I think we can say that was an illuminating perspective.
So next up, we'll have Gabe Lucci. He'll be providing that voice that's a mix between Fergie and Jesus.
Now, it appears that Gabe has brought a friend with him tonight who is currently squeaking across the stage. I'd like everyone to give a hand for Mark.
I wrote a song. It's called We Are Gonna Be Friends by the White Stripes. It's dedicated to someone very special. She knows who she is. Here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Alex K, through the park and by the bay, we will rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. Safely walk to school without a sound. Here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt on our uniform from chasing all the ants and worms. We the up. We numbers, letters, learn to spell, nouns and books and show and tell. Playtime, we will throw the ball, back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. We don't notice any time pass. We don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes the way you sing. Tonight I'll dream when I'm in bed, when silly thoughts go through my head about the ants and alphabet. But when I wake tomorrow, I bet that you and I will walk together again. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
So, we're gonna have more music, and Dan Raffo will be playing the piano. Up next, AJ Nielsen will be doing his very best impersonation of Tom Cruise.
Days.
After that energizing act, James Zingarini is now going to also be wowing the crowd tonight with some male modeling. Soon. Thanks. So can we get a round of applause to maybe get James out here tonight?
Yeah, they're calling.
I don't know if that's quite loud enough to do it.
All right, so we need to roll with me.
I think it's time to start chanting James.
Why were you here?
Your boss is so
pretty. We need more people.
You're excused, and I'm not your bra, or any form of underwear for that matter. Boxers, briefs, you get the idea. Listen, Davish, I'm tired of your stuff, man. I should have been hosting that talent show, man. I should have been hosting that talent show. That's just me, man.
Oh, I see how it is. Well, you know, Jim, I see a little way to settle this, actually.
What you got? Well, huh?
It's a walk-off.
It's a walk-off. It's a walk-off. It's a walk-off.
I believe I can be of some assistance here. Come here. All right. Hey, come here. All right. Old school rules. First model walks, second model duplicates, and then let's do this.
Baker, who's on the baseball team, will be switching sports for tonight. It appears that our Northwestern committed friend has been bested by a baseball player. Up next, we have Rye Hollister. And Rye will quite literally be fighting a panda while invisible. So keep that in mind. Thank you. It seems like a lot of our senior boys really need a lot of coaxing tonight. I don't know if you know Rye. He doesn't really strike me as the shy type, but I think maybe he might need another round of applause.
Okay, enough of this fun. Bring out the panda. Let's go, bud.
Fight, fight.
Okay, okay. Let's go, fool. Huh? Oh, you're a panda bear. Guess what? I'm invisible. Let's go. Bring it, bud. Yeah, right here. Oh, wait a minute. I'm over here. Bam! Endanger this. Hey, what's black, white, and red all over? Feeling bamboozled? Oh no, I guess the audience can't bear to watch this. Take this. Oh dear.
Ow. Ow, my nose. Ouch. I think it's bleeding. Okay, I'm done. I'm getting off stage. Act's over, guys. Ow. 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 Ow.
Thank you.
So I think we can all agree that that was incredibly original. But up next, we have Council Rock North's own Jason Chevelle. And Jason tonight will be trying to prove to our judges up front that he is the world's greatest.
I'm the world's greatest. I'm the world's greatest. I'm the world's greatest. I am a mountain. I am a tall tree. Oh, I am a swift wind sweeping the country. I am a river down in the valley. Oh, I am a hero. I am a hero. Oh, if anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look him in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. Ooh, I'm the world's greatest. I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's against the rope, I can feel it. Ooh, I'm the world's greatest. 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 I am a giant. I am an eagle. Oh, I am a lion down in the jungle. I am a marching band. I am the people. Oh, I am a helping hand. I am a hero. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look him in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. Ooh, I'm the world's greatest. I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's against the road, I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest. In the rain of life, I rain love. I will reign. Oh yeah. I shine a light in the world in me. I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. Feel it. Ooh, I'm the world's greatest. Woo-hoo!
So up next, we have Devin McIntyre, who's going to try to convince all the kids to read.
There's supposed to be a microphone stand, so thanks a lot, SEB.
Butterfly in the sky, I can fly twice as high. Just take a look, it's in a book, Reading Rainbow. I can do anything. Just take a look, it's in a book, Reading Rainbow. It's Reading Rainbow. Reading Rainbow. Reading Rainbow.
There we go. Our last talent for the evening is Andre, and he's going to be proving that nobody puts Andy in a corner by dancing dirty. Welcome back, Lauren.
Now I had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
'Cause I had the time of my life, and I owe.
So long now, I finally found someone to stand by me.
We saw the writing on the wall as we felt this magical fantasy.
Now with passion in our eyes, there's no way we could disguise it secretly. So we take each other's hand, 'cause we seem to understand.
I think he gets this from me.
Just remember.
With my body.
Thank you guys for sharing your impressive talents. We'll be now taking a 15-minute intermission, and there are refreshments available in the cafeteria.
Please don't forget to vote for Mr. Legs. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We've seen the guys trying to impress the audience with their talents, but now it's time for them to make the ladies swoon with an original pickup line. First up, we have Alex Sobel escorting Camille Smith.
Hey there, beautiful. Want to be with an alpha dog?
Next up, we have Alan Wong escorting Katie Adams.
I've never had to do this before, but I like you. Please go out with me.
Now we have Rye Hollister escorting Dylan McKessie.
Let's make a Dylan sandwich with two hearty slices of rye.
Up next, AJ Nielsen is accompanied by Kara McCullough.
I might not have my invisibility cloak, but do you think I could still see your restricted section at night?
Next we have James Zingarini escorting Askew Blankmeyer.
I've said this once, and I'll say it again. Askew, I'm sorry. I promise I won't let anything like that happen to you again. I realize now how much I care about you, and I promise that I'll never treat you wrong ever again. Do you accept my apology?
Dan Raffo, escorted by Avery Allen.
See your hand? I'm drawing a bunny in a river.
What was that for?
I just want an excuse to hold your hand.
Next, we have Gabe Lucci, who's being escorted by Christina Tenalucci.
Hey girl, what's your sign? Is it Pi over 2? Because you're the one.
Up next, Ryan Baker's being brought up by Laura Kwasnowski.
If I had 5 cents for every time I saw a girl as beautiful as you,
I'd have a nickel.
I'd have a nickel.
We now have Matt Jaquinski escorting Megan Montgomery.
Just let it happen.
My first love, your every breath.
Just let it happen.
Jason Chevelle, escorting Ricky Abrams.
Hey, Ricky, I talked to your father, I talked to the Yenta. Oh, it's gonna be a beautiful wedding. Oh, your bubbler, she is so proud. Hey!
Devin McIntyre escorting Yinzi in.
Are you a book? Because I'd like to cuddle up in a bed and start a new chapter with you.
And finally, Andre Tarasuk escorting Brittany Weldy.
All right, so who am I picking up?
Me, obviously.
It's a lot easier than I thought.
All right, guys, this one.
What are you doing? Oh, my gosh.
So we're going to give our judges a few minutes to deliberate after being wowed by those creative pickup lines. We'd like to thank Shuian's Tuxes once again for the generous donations for tonight's competition. Turns out the boys clean up pretty well.
So now that we've seen these contestants perform their special talents and their special pickup lines, it's time to test their ability under pressure with our question and answer portion of the evening.
Each contestant will draw a question out of the hat and give us their best answer on the spot.
C
soon.
Who will be first? Devin. You can hand staff your question.
Devin has randomly drawn. If you chose to stay a certain age forever, what age would it be and why?
Age 13. I peaked at age 13. Everything's been downhill since then.
So now we're gonna go down the line. Sorry, Devin. Sobel.
Has randomly drawn question number 4. What is your favorite word and why?
Happy, because I'm happy. Good night.
Alan.
Alan, what is your favorite smell and why?
Larissa Witt.
Rye.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Rye, if you could hang out with one TV star for a day, who would it be and what would you do?
Well, whether or not this would happen, I always wanted to hang out with Glenn Hurricane Schwartz because I feel like he's a lot to say, and he's a large party animal.
Thank you, Rye. AJ.
No. AJ, what famous person does your personality most parallel? Why?
Well, you see, Arnold Palmer, because he's a great man, and I'm a great man, and we smell the world together.
James.
No. James, if we came over to your house for dinner, what food would you prepare and why?
Well, that is a simple question. My good friend Ferguson Ammo, when he first moved in with us, his parents were kind enough to sacrifice a live goat on our kitchen counter. The goat was 400 pounds, and we still had some leftovers in the freeze, and I can make a mean goat stew. Enjoy.
Dan.
Dan, if you were a Crayola crown, what color would you be and why?
Fuzzy, wuzzy brown. Because I'm very fuzzy and wuzzy.
Gabe.
Gabe, if you could be any item in Bed, Bath, and Beyond, which would you be and why?
I would be the assistant manager, just so I could have supremacy over everyone who ever lived.
Ryan.
Okay, now pick two celebrities to be your parents and explain.
All right, Tina Fey, enough said. And Robert Downey Jr. I got the hair, man.
Matt.
Matt, what is your biggest pet peeve and why?
When people use quotation marks incorrectly, okay? I was driving by this church by my house, and there was like a sign for a charity, right? And they said, we're helping parents of kids with autism. What do they mean by autism? Are they implying that these kids are trying to fake it? It's rude, and we need to fix this.
Thank you.
Jason.
Jason, what time period do you wish you had been born into and why?
I think if I had to pick, there are a lot of really great ones. But as a Jew, I think I would feel safest in like 1930s, 40s Europe. It was really, you know, the highlight of my period.
Andy. Andy, if you could kick one state out of the United States, which state would it be?
New Jersey.
Thanks.
So that concludes our final portion of Mr. CRN for this evening. While we give our judges a chance to deliberate tonight's results, let's announce this year's Mr. Legs. So now that we've explained what Mr. Legs is to you, our winner raised a startling $96.38.
Purely all, with their legs.
Which, if you didn't notice, just to give you a little hint, were shaved in stripes horizontally. Which means that the winner for this year's Mr. Legs is Matt Jaquinski.
All of the money raised by Matt for his legs and all of the money raised by the other contestants will go to the charity of Matt's choice.
Matt's charity is March of Dimes. March of Dimes will now be receiving the pooled results of everybody's legs. So thank you, everybody. Are we ready with the results? Or do we need a little more time? You know what? I think this would be a great time to get some predictions from the audience.
So,
yeah.
Just...
It seems that there's some sort of coalition forming.
So just to recap, what the winner is going to receive, two pair of free prom tickets to senior prom. Okay, one pair, two tickets.
Glad you guys are all on top of your education as second semester seniors.
A free tux rental.
From Shuyan's Tuxes, who I think we can all agree made the boys look very dapper this evening.
And the title of Mr. CRN.
And everything that comes with it, ladies.
I love you so.
All right, we still need a minute.
Let's go interview the contestants.
Yep, this way.
Devin. How are you feeling right now?
Good. I'm feeling peachy.
How are you feeling, Jason?
I'm excited. This is fun.
I'm actually glad people appreciate my legs.
Intimidated by his leg.
All right, I guess.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm ecstatic.
Next question.
Sweat.
I peed a little.
I
I don't know.
There you go.
A lot better than the time I did that Fox News interview.
I think the judges are ready. So it's time to grab our results. I'm sure Ben Wild has his own opinions to add. I don't know where I'm going.
Steph.
Where are they?
Can I have a drum roll, please? And the winner of tonight's Mr. CRN. Andre Tarasuk.
Nick Mila Strong. So all of the money that we raised tonight goes to Nick Mila. Andy also won a free tuxedo rental from Shuyans, Texas, and two prom tickets to senior prom. Our evening's activities.
Be sure to join us at our next event, Rockathon. Thank you.
Oh, and by the way, Rockathon, no, don't.